بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. السلام علیکم ڈیئر اسٹوڈنٹس, آئی ایم یور پاکستان اسٹڈیز ٹیچر, اینڈ ٹوڈے وی آر گوئنگ ٹو اسٹڈی ان ڈیٹیل دا ٹاپک وچ از جنرل ایوب خان اینڈ مارشل لاء آف 1958. So let's start the topic, and first of all I'll tell you about a little bit about the background of the imposition of martial law in 1958. So the first president of Pakistan, Iskandar Mirza, only for his personal interest abrogated the constitution of 1956, and he promulgated martial law in the country on 7th October 1958. And the army chief, General Ayub Khan, was appointed as chief martial law administrator. But what did Ayub Khan do? He only after 20 days forced Iskandar Mirza to resign the office of president and was exiled. He himself assumed, he means General Ayub Khan, means General Ayub Khan himself assumed the power, and political system was abolished on 27th October 1958 accordingly. So this was the first martial law in the country, and these three, four lines are the background of the imposition of martial law. Now, there were a lot of causes of promulgation of martial law or the imposition of martial law in Pakistan. In those causes, we are going to study some causes like I have just written it on this page. Worst economic condition. Worst economic condition. Political stability is necessary for economic stability of the country, which was becoming bad in the country day by day, and the country was not progressing accordingly. Basically, Pakistan is an agricultural country, you all know that, but at that time Pakistan was importing some basic food items also, and that was very shame for Pakistan. Side by side, smuggling, black marketing and hoarding were also at the peak, and smuggling in the country had adopted the shape of a kind of business. People even did not bother about the smuggling, and effective people, they were supporting those people who were smugglers. The next reason was political disorder. As you already read that political stability is very necessary for a country to get progress. But the political situation in the country was not good at that time. And right from the time when Pakistan came into being, people together with the political leaders made efforts to move the country towards development. But up to 1957, political conditions of the country had been much deteriorated. Deteriorated means the conditions were very worst, bad. And the position of political differences was that different ministers of the government were not functioning satisfactorily. Their performance was not satisfactory. So this causes political disorder in the country, and that ended in the shape of martial law. The next reason, which is third number, is the worst trade condition. Worst trade conditions. Like political and economic conditions, trade conditions was also hopeless enough. Profiteering and adulteration in food stuff had been common. Profiteering, munafakhori. Adulteration, milawat. Demand for our goods and raw materials in the world market was near to finish. And the ruling class did not take any steps for its improvement. Pakistani currency was devalued, and for the completion of all developmental projects, Pakistan remained dependent on Western countries. In addition, industrial development was in a very slow motion. Strikes, lockouts, and industrial conflicts were the daily routine matters. As a result, the people become distrustful from the rulers. Strikes mean hartale wagaira. Lockouts, dukane band karna. The next reason number four of the imposition of martial law, is social defects. The effects of political and economic mismanagement in the country was creating sharply the feelings of strangeness. Log apne aap ko ajnabi mehsoos kar rahe the. Provincial prejudice was enhancing. Distance between both parts of the country further spread over. Therefore, the people wished for a solid change which may cause for the democracy, equality, economic and social happiness of the people. Socially, the country was in very worse condition, and the things between East Pakistan and West Pakistan became very worst. The East Pakistanis were feeling West Pakistanis as their enemies. Okay, the last reason, miscellaneous problems. Along with the weakness in political institution in the country, the sense of responsibility was missing in the politicians' role and bureaucracy. They preferred their own interest on the national and public interest. Besides the role of the important pillars of the government, for example, judiciary, was also not commendable. It was not functioning well. In addition, the pending problems of the country, for example, the rehabilitation of refugees, canal water dispute, and the Kashmir issue, remained unsolved and no one tried for their solution. These were very important problems which Pakistan had to solve, but no one were bothering about these problems. In these circumstances, Iskandar Mirza abolished the constitution, cancelled the constitution, and promulgated martial law in the country. Promulgated means imposed martial law in the country, which badly shocked the democratic process. As you all know that from the very beginning, Pakistan was facing a lot of problems, which we already discussed at the beginning of chapter number 4 on the first page. But from 1947 to 1957, almost, there are 10 years. And in those 10 years, Pakistan became worst. As the leaders, Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah and Liaquat Ali Khan died, and then all these problems came to surface. So these were the causes of martial law of Ayub Khan. And before it, we already read about the background of the martial law of 1958. Hopefully, you will have a better understanding. Thank you very much.